Espiritu.
Amen.
Bakit ka manatili? Bakit ka nananatili? Why did you stay? Karen pong opisina at ilang ako siya na exit interview. Potang ating mag-resign, ating mama ko, yung human resource officer interview nala. Kudnane, o ba't mama ko ka? Why are you leaving? Madakal labi eh dahilan. Mag-abroad ko, manto ko mas masanti nga obra, eko buri keni, masayiting obra keni, dakala biyeng dahilan. Ako suggest ko naman kareng mag-obra kareng human resource officials na edala mo kukunan detang mama ko o ba't mama ko la. Masanting lawan dala retang manatili. Detang eh mama ko at kunan dala, why are you staying? Bakit ka nananatili? Masanting yan naman sigurong pigunaman ito o tela mama ko o tela titipla tela manaliwaisip. Bala mo, hindi kayo. Hindi kayo sisimba. O sisimba ko po. O manatili kayo. Samantalang karakalda rin alin na sisimba. O kaya ay no, pupunta pisamba. In the gospel, in piyesta tamo po ngayon in Dolores. At Maria, ima ng Jesus. May natili ya, enelikwan ni Jesus. Makatalakad ya, king bitisan ng krus na. When everyone abandoned Jesus, Mary's mother stayed standing by the foot of the cross. Bakit nanatili si Maria at hindi niya iniwanan si Jesus? Yung ibang mga disipulo, apostoles, iniwanan si Jesus sa takot. They wanted to save their lives. Si Maria nanatili at hindi niya iniwanan si Jesus dahil sa matinding pagmamahal niya bilang ina. Because of her love for Jesus, her tough love for her son Jesus. For Jesus also, in the beginning of his ministry, he went through what they call desert experience as a test to his faithfulness to his father. It was tough love. He was tested, he was hungry, he was weak, and he made to go through the discipline of his training. And he was tempted by the devil at this very point. He has to fight the evil one in flesh of his humanity that is not relying on divine power alone. That he has to learn to deal with many kinds of people in this world. Allowing them to experience the consequences of their decisions and actions. Neng kayo po masyado talang poprotektan din anak. Ila na may kamali. E tala pa paboren mabiyasa at magsisiking karelang pa magkamali. Let us not shield them from realities or overprotecting them. Let them face realities. E po balo nung akwento ko na kanita deng anak potang magkamali la deng kaya tala man kamuanan e tala man pabalo karelang pa magkamali da. Paboren tala pang nengkay kusintirulan tala pa. Halimbawa, yung apo mo, nganak mo, lalakad ya, bagya-bagya pa lalakad. Kaya ba't kayong pa maglakad na mipukpuk ya? Mipukpuk ya kayong. Mipukpuk ya kayong lamisita. Kaya ba't kayo, lola, lola, pukpuk. Pula besa, lukulo, bukol, bukol. Eh, ba't sabihan mo kanito, may bukulang ka, ano kami pupukin? Kasalanan na nila mesa, hindi paluan tayo, kagiga. Yung kasalanan na lula mesa. Yan, pinalo ko na ilang mesa yung nakakikiyak. O, ito yung tuturuta ka rin, anak tamo? Ilamig ka mali ka, ba't paluwal mo yung lamesa? O tem na sabihan, susunod ba kakalali na ka mo, anak? E kamula-mulala. I mean, you have to be careful, otherwise you will really hurt yourself. So, pigpok mo yung buntok mo, Ken. O susunod, pupukon na naman yung butok na kita at saka na ipapalo ka lola na. We never learn. Maybe the harsh reality is to tell them you are responsible for your life. Lalo na po tantutuwa na lang. You can blame others, even question God. But ultimately, you are in charge with what happens to you. Nang kahit ang anak niya anyway, pati yung Diyos, sisisyende, pati yung Diyos ko nande pa, they begin to question God. But ultimately, ang giyang ninusisyan mo, ni kamuanan mo, ikapamurin, yung dapat malalakaran kay MBA mo. Nga na pinitang kanta ng Dean Arden Anderson, baluya po yun, I beg your pardon, I never promised you a rose garden. Nepo. Pero even the rose garden will always have thorns. We were not raised as weaklings, but we were prepared to be tough. Eta mo maging lampa, batak sa trabaho, taga sa panahon, nga da rin Tagalog. Tough love also involves caring on the mission even in the midst of adversity. Like Jesus did, Pete de Juan Bautista tip-top de battle, nang gawa ng Jesus, sinalikutya, minurong niya. After the death of John the Baptist, Jesus, on a spiritual training of discipline, he was not wallowing of self-pity and fear in times of trials and difficulties. But in that most difficult time, he launched his ministry. Even St. Paul, in his own ministry, kukwento ng San Pablo ka rin kaya sulat 2 Timothy 4 verse 2. Proclaim the word, be persistent, whether it is convenient or inconvenient. Convince, reprimand, encourage through all patience and teaching. He also says in 2 Corinthians 11, 22-28, that he has been through far greater labors, far more imprisonments, far worse beatings, and numerous bruises with death. Ang giyang isan San Pablo, kinwento na may katapilan niya mesukul, kapilan niya diksu mete, at kapilan de bigbugan, king kayang pangasukul. He also talks in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, we are troubled on every side, not yet distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed. Our Christian faith, like blossom in the midst of suffering, crucifixion, and even death itself. Tough love. O yan po, ingat ka nakikata mo. Bantangin mo, eta mo, susuko. Neng kailawe ta mo keng lugod, romantic, romantikong lugod. Ating bulaklak, ating chocolate, ating regalo, ating love song. Pero yung tunay lugod, potang ala, potang masakit at potang masakit, manatili ka pa mo rin. Let your love be nourished by our faith and our love that makes us strong. King Israel, atin lang metong expression, ingaus da ka rin anak da sabra. Nepo. Ating metong pari, King Korea, mag-complain niya nga na, o kaya King Israel, anong karakal ding outstanding citizen? Labi lang at luyata, may git, ding karelang, if I'm not mistaken, they have more than 13 Nobel Peace Awardees. 13, science, medicine. Kaya ba't po, samantalang ding taga-Israel, analakaritak, magit lang 9 million. Ika mi keng South Korea, 51 million. Pilipinas, ita mo, magit ang 113 million. O tila, karitak damo, pero karakalda rin biyasa karela in Israel. Kaila, internationally, outstanding lang. Sabi na kasi, ngaos da rin anak, sabra. Nandun si sabra. They're called cactus. Bali rin cactus. Detang ang yang atsula kayong balas, ang yang emo tutugtugan, ang yang ating ubingan, ang yang mapali, ang yang alandanom, mabibiel, sabrang at ikay, usan may anak mong kaktos, o kamuha na, buri na sa buri, no? Itang siguro mas ating orchids, mga yan, rose, well. Pero itang kaktos, eh, may usan kaktos yung anak mo. Pero ila, usan ka rin anak na kaktos. Burida kasi, like Israel, they are in the midst of desert and nothingness, dryness and rough. They still prevail. Mabibiyela pa mo rin. At maging lang masikan. Makanyaning ausaning lugod King Diyos kaya ta. Masakit, mabayat, kalupaning lugod ng Maria kang Jesus. Pero ikita mo, manalakaran niya, sabra ing lugod ng Maria. May natiliya, ay ameko. Keti Pilipinas at intamo na mga buring, ako at ikong buring bulakla, keti Pilipinas. Baluyo po rin, bonggabilya. Den bonggabilya. Den bonggabilya, ang giyange mo tugtugan. Ang giyange mo banten. Bumiel. Ang giyange mo sesen. They bloom best during the peak of summer, dry, hot sun, and scorching heat. Potande ang aluwang tanaman, may nanala. Potande ang aluwang tanaman, may langina, lawling mapali. Ba, den bonggabilya, kantala mamukadkad, bulaklak. King pali, king kasakitan. Sabi dapin, they bloom even when they are neglected. Ang yami paboren la, mamulaklak la pa rin. Yara kang anak, sana maging bonggabilya. Bonggang-bongga. Bilya, nga muna-muna. Bakit po? Kasi din bonggabilya. Ang giyange mo masyadong tutugtugan. Giyange mo si Kaso. Gawan day lubda. Sana makanyanla naman din, anak. Ela masaingsing. Ela papasese. Ela masyadong, aray, pipaburenko, edang si Kaso. We are not trained to be like that. We are Christians. The tough love of Jesus for His Father, even until the cross. The tough love of Mary by the foot of the cross. Naapun, pigmasusyan tayo pa mo ing tagumpe ng krus. Ngayon, pagmasusyan tayo mo ing tagumpe ng malalam matibe ng lugod Maria, king anak na. They do not only remain, they bloom. Deng bonggabilya, ela manatili. Matingkad lang mamulaklak keng kasakitan at pali na ning panahon. Iting kaya katang maya pabalita. Iting kaya katamong pigunaman. Kilagyo ningig pa ang paninganak, panimbanan ng Espiritu.
Amen.